Hello friends, welcome back to our video lecture series on course titled Fluid Mechanics 2. In this lecture, we will continue with our previous topic, impact object and case 2, when object is moving. This will be our last condition, what we are going to discuss in this lecture. As usual, we will just go through our previous discussion, what we have made. We have discussed case number 1, when object was stationary, we have derived all those equations. For the case number 1, for the different conditions, so you can just simply pause this video here and you can just recall those equation of the forces, what we have derived by using impulse momentum principle. Again, similarly, we have discussed case 2, and in the case 2 we have discussed three different conditions, and in this lecture we are going to discuss our last condition. So for the every condition, we have derived the equation for the force exerted by the jet on plate, whether it is curved or whether it is inclined or whether it is normal to the jet or direction of jet. So again, you can simply pause this video here and you can go through those equations of the force what we have derived previously. Simply, you can remember the difference between our stationary object equation of the force and moving object equation of the force. If you see here, f of x is given by rho a p minus u whole square, and if you see our stationary condition, when it was given by rho a v square. So we are just simply replacing this v with the relative velocity v minus u. Now let's move to our today's or last condition what we are going to discuss. Our jet of fluid striking tangentially on the unsymmetrical plate when it is moving with the velocity u. So we are going to discuss this case. Now let us consider unsymmetrical curved vane. Now when curved vane is said to be unsymmetrical, obviously if I draw the tangent at the tip of the curved vane, like say tangent at this point and tangent at this point, then those both tangent are going to make different angle with respect to the horizontal. So this tangent making an angle theta with respect to horizontal, and this tangent making an angle phi with respect to the horizontal. In case of symmetrical curved vane, those both angle will be the same, that is theta is equal to phi, but in this case both would be the different. Now on this curved vane, my jet of fluid coming with the velocity v1 and striking this jet at the point 1 tangentially, that is mean that my jet is making an angle alpha with respect to the direction of motion. I am going to leave the curved vane at the point 2. So my jet or jet of fluid going to follow the contour of this particular curved vane, or going to glide over this curved vane. Now as I am considering my jet coming tangentially and striking on the curved vane tangentially, so whatever the loss of energy due to the impact, that will be zero. So as we are considering tangential entry of the jet, loss of energy due to the impact will be zero. Now if I am considering my this plate is also moving with the velocity u1, now in that case whatever the velocity of strike of the jet will be with the relative velocity. Now before proceeding for the discussion of relative velocity or velocity of striking of the jet, we will first define our inlet point and outlet point. So what is my inlet point here? The point from where my jet of fluid getting enter to the curved vane, that is point 1, is known as inlet point, and the point 2 where my jet of fluid going to leave the curved vane, that is said to be a outlet point. So at the inlet point, jet getting inside to the curved vane and going to glide over the curved vane, and at the outlet point it is going to leave the curved vane. Now whatever the angle measured by drawing tangent at this inlet point is known as inlet tip angle, or whatever this point is known as inlet tip, and angle measured by drawing tangent at the inlet tip is known as inlet tip angle, or also said to be a vane angle at the inlet, which is represented by theta. Similarly, if I consider the outlet tip or outlet point, any tangent drawn at the outlet and angle is measured with respect to the horizontal is known as outlet tip angle or vane angle at the outlet. Now let us consider my velocity at the inlet, velocity of this curved vane or peripheral velocity, or also said to be a tangential velocity of the curved vane at the inlet point is u1, and tangential velocity at the outlet is u2. Now I can simply determine a relative velocity here. Now if you consider this is your u1 and v1, just remember that whatever the inlet point and outlet point, all the parameters with the suffix 1 are going to represent value of that parameter at inlet point, and all the parameters with the suffix 2 are going to represent value of that parameter at the outlet point. Now as I said, we can simply compute the relative velocity here, but if you can see here, as we know, velocity is the vector quantity, so we need to consider its direction as well while determining it. So in the previous cases, how we have calculated relative velocity? By simply considering v minus u, that is difference between jet velocity and plate velocity. In this case, If I see this V1 or jet which is making an angle alpha with respect to the horizontal, we cannot simply take here that V1 minus U1. Why? Because both are moving in the different direction. So this calculation or computation of relative velocity will be wrong. So in that case, we can simply do one thing. We can just resolve this component in two direction, one component acting in horizontal direction, another component is acting in vertical direction. And from this horizontal component, we are going to deduct this U1 and we can simply determine our relative velocity. Now with that relative velocity, my jet of water is going to strike at the inlet tip and going to glide over it and going to leave the outlet tip. So hope you understood this, what is the phenomena is going to take place here. Now if I see here, whatever my direction of jet before striking to the plate, that was something like this, but after striking it was just glided over the plate and going to move in this particular direction. What is happening here? My jet is getting deflected due to this curved vane, and that's what we are going to represent, that deflection, that mean by measuring the angle of deflection. So what will be the angle of deflection? My jet was previously going in this direction and now it is deflected in this direction. So this will be my angle of deflection, and which will be given by this 180, this whole 180 minus theta plus phi. So I can simply calculate my angle of deflection of jet, 180 minus theta plus phi. Hope you understood this. So let's proceed for our computation of relative velocity and absolute velocity, or for the discussion of the construction of the triangles, velocity triangles at the inlet and at the outlet, because as we have discussed, here our plate is moving as well as this jet is also striking with the relative velocity. So we can simply draw velocity triangle at the inlet and at the outlet for the computation of various parameter of this particular case. So as we have discussed, we are going to construct inlet velocity triangle and outlet velocity triangle in this condition. So before construction, let us define V1 and V2 are the absolute velocity of the jet at inlet and at outlet. U1 and U2 are the peripheral velocities of the vane at the inlet and at the outlet respectively. Here it is U1 and U2. VR1 and VR2 are the relative velocities at the inlet and at the outlet. VF1 and VF2 are the velocity of flow at two different places. VW1 and VW2 are the velocities of whirl at inlet and at outlet. Theta and phi are the tip angle at inlet and outlet, are also said to be vane angles at the inlet and at the outlet. Alpha and beta are the angle made by the absolute velocity at inlet and at outlet with respect to the horizontal or with respect to the x-axis. Remember that all the angles are measured with respect to the horizontal or with respect to the x-axis. Now let's proceed. We are simply going to derive here, construct inlet and outlet velocity triangle. I have made separate video for this construction of inlet and outlet velocity triangle. You can refer it as well. So we will just recall that video. Let us consider a curved vane which is moving with the velocity U1 and U2 at inlet and at outlet. Now let us consider our jet, fluid jet, coming with the velocity V1 and striking or getting entered to this curved vane tangentially. As it is coming tangentially, obviously whatever the energy loss due to the impact will be the zero. Now this V1 making an angle alpha with respect to the horizontal or with respect to the x-axis. So I can simply resolve it into two components. One is the horizontal, which is given by V cos of alpha, and one is the vertical, which is known as V1 sine of alpha. So I am just simply considering this horizontal component and vertical component. By taking this horizontal component and deducting this U1 from the horizontal component, we can simply calculate relative velocity, that is given by V1 cos of alpha minus U1. As vector quantity, velocity is the vector quantity. We can simply calculate by taking its difference of those two vectors of the velocity which are moving in the same direction, VW1 minus U1. So if I draw that U1 here by taking similar scale, and if I draw that V1 here, so I will get another point at this point, and this will be over my point of relative velocity. By drawing the same line from this point to this point, I will get the component of relative velocity, and this is what our relative velocity. So this will be our relative velocity. So if I am considering here, this is my point A. If I am considering here, this is my point B, and if this is my point C, in that case this ABC is referred as inlet velocity triangle. Now for the smooth entry of the jet, whatever this theta should be equal to inlet tip angle of this particular plate. So whatever my theta should be equal to whatever the angle made by the tangent at the inlet of the curved vein or a vein angle of the inlet. Otherwise, this jet may create a noise here or may create a shocks here. So for the smooth entry of this jet, this angle made by relative velocity, that should be equal to the angle at the inlet tip of the vein. So that's how we have defined our inlet velocity triangle. So remember that this ABC is the inlet velocity triangle. Now let's move to the outlet point or to the outlet velocity triangle. Now what we are getting here, VR1, and if I am considering whatever my this plate is smooth, so if my plate is smooth, obviously whatever my relative velocity at inlet point will remain same at the outlet point. So whenever my jet is leaving, it is going to leave with the relative velocity VR1, so that velocity will be similar. Practically it may not possible. So practically if I am considering this is VR1 and at the outlet relative velocity is VR2, in that case my VR1 will be always greater than VR2. Again, another small assumption we are going to made here, we are going to consider the elevation difference between those two points is very small. So due to that small consideration or small assumption, we can simply say that my VR1 will be equal to VR2, and I can simply draw the first component which is coming out at the outlet, that is VR2. So this will be my VR2. Now for the smooth leaving of the jet without making any shocks, this angle made by this VR2 should be equal to outlet tip angle of the curved vein. So whatever this phi should be equal to this one. So I have just extended this line of outlet tip angle and I have just drawn it on VR2, that is relative velocity at the outlet. Now once I draw the relative velocity and once I draw it on the angle phi, the angle made by relative velocity with the horizontal is phi, I can simply draw the U2 at the outlet. So after drawing U2 here, I can simply define our absolute velocity at the outlet. So here I am going to draw the, first I am going to draw DE, then I am going to draw EF is equal to U2, and after that this F point will be get joined to the D, and this DF is going to represent absolute velocity which is going to make an angle beta with respect to the horizontal. Now there may be another possibility that this beta will be greater than 90 degree. If you see here, it is looks like less than 90 degree. It is less than 90 degree actually, not looks like. And that beta may be greater than 90 degree or may be equal to 90 degree. So for all the condition we have to consider, all those condition we have to consider while determining the equation for the force. Now once we draw this V2, we can simply resolve it into two component, vertical and horizontal, VF2 and VW2. Now once we complete this drawing of the velocity vector or velocity triangle at the inlet and at the outlet, if you see here, whatever the angle DEF, this triangle is known as outlet velocity triangle. Again, VF2 and VW2 are the resolving component of V2. Again, here we have shown angle of deflection by which my angle has been, my jet has been deflected, which is given by 180 minus theta plus phi. Hope you understood this. So we can simply determine the force exerted by the jet of fluid on the this curved vein. So we are just simply going to determine it by using impulse momentum principle. Now if we are considering this curved vein is fixed on the wheel, and if it is smooth, then in that case obviously this V1 will be equal to V2, and that can be represented as U, that is tangential or peripheral velocity of the vein at the inlet and at the outlet. Again, VR1 is equal to VR2 if I am considering plate is smooth, so my relative velocity at the inlet and at the outlet will remain same. Now a mass of water striking to the plate per second is given by mass of fluid flowing per second is equal to density multiplied by discharge. Mass per second is given by density multiplied by area multiplied by velocity of strike. Now with which velocity my jet of fluid is going to strike on the plate, that is given by relative velocity. So our mass of fluid striking per second is given by rho a multiplied by VR1. Remember that what we are considering here, VR1, that is relative velocity at the inlet. In the previous case we have discussed it as V minus U, but in this case we are just considering it as VR1, and VR1 is given by the equation, VR1 is given by the equation VW1 minus U1. This will be our relative velocity at the inlet. Now we can simply compute the force exerted by the jet on the plate by considering impulse momentum principle, which is given by rate of change of momentum in the same direction in which direction force is acting. So if I am considering f of x, force exerted by the jet in x direction, is equal to rate of change of momentum in x direction. Now it is simply, it can be simply calculated as f of x is equal to mass per second multiplied by initial velocity minus final velocity. So velocity of striking and velocity after striking, which is given by velocity of striking. Now if I'm considering my force which is acting in x direction, if I'm considering my direction of motion or direction of force is this one, so we need to consider velocity component in this direction, in the horizontal direction. But if you see here, my relative velocity is acting with the certain angle theta, so I can simply resolve it into two component, vertical and horizontal, which is shown here by this triangle. So just I have resolved this vr1 with respect to the horizontal in two component. One is acting in horizontal direction, vr1 cos of theta, and another is vertical, vr1 sin of theta. Similarly, at the outlet, we need to compute the final velocity. So for the final velocity, we need to resolve this vr2 in horizontal direction and in vertical direction. So here, simply I have just resolved it into two direction, vr2 cos of phi horizontal component, vr2 sin of phi vertical component. Now what will be my initial velocity? Initial velocity will be the vr1 cos of theta. So here it is, vr1 cos of theta. And my final velocity in direction of motion or in x direction, that will be this one, horizontal component of this vr2, that is vr2 cos of phi. As it is showing the opposite direction, that is direction of force, in which direction my force is acting, rightward direction. It is acting in leftward direction, so it is taken as minus vr2 cos of phi. Now by simply putting this equation, these values in the equation of impulse momentum principle, what equation we will get here? Rho a vr1, that is mass of fluid flowing or striking per second to the curved bend, multiplied by vr1 cos of theta minus minus vr2 cos of phi. This minus minus will become plus. So here I have written that vr1 cos of theta plus vr2 cos of phi. Now this is the case when our angle beta is less than 90 degree. As I told you, this beta may be greater than 90 degree, this beta may be equal to 90 degree. So we will consider all those cases. In the first case, our beta is less than 90 degree. Now when beta is less than 90 degree, our velocity triangle at the inlet will be look like this. Now by considering this triangle, we can simply calculate from the inlet and outlet velocity, we can simply define this phi and theta. We can simply replace this cos of theta or vr1 cos of theta or vr2 cos of phi. So let us consider our beta is less than 90 degree. In that case, from inlet velocity triangle, what we are getting here, cos of theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. So if I am considering this cos of theta, what is my hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is vr1, and what is my adjacent? Adjacent will be this portion. And now how we can calculate this portion? By taking vw1 minus u1. So I can simply define here cos of theta is equal to vw1 minus u1 divided by vr1. So I can simply write down by taking this vr1 on right hand side, vr1 cos of theta is equal to vw1 minus u1. So I can simply put this value in this equation. Now again, similarly, by looking to the outlet velocity triangle, I can simply define as vr cos of phi is equal to u2 plus vw2 divided by vr2. So whatever the adjacent divided by this hypotenuse. So here I am taking cos of phi is equal to vw2 plus u2 divided by vr2. So by taking this vr2 again on right hand left hand side, what I will get here, vr2 cos of phi is equal to vw2 u2. Again I am going to simply put this value in the our very first equation what we have derived for the f of x. Now by putting those values in this equation, what we will get here, rho a vr1 multiplied by vw1 minus u1 plus vw2 plus u2. So this u1 and u2 will get cancelled. What equation I am left with, because what we have assumed that u1 and u2 are equal if this wheel is fixed. So in that case, what equation we are getting for the force exerted by the jet on the curved moving vane when it is unsymmetrical, it is given by f of x is equal to rho a vr1 multiplied by vw1 plus vw2. So this will be our force exerted by the jet when our angle beta is less than 90 degree. That means that our angle beta is acute angle. So there may be another two possibility, that this beta will be equal to 90 degree, or this beta will be equal to greater than 90 degree. So those we will discuss. So to understood this derivation, let's move to the next case when our beta may be equal to greater than 90 degree. That is mean that beta is obtuse angle. Now when my beta is obtuse angle, obviously cos of theta will remain same. Cos of theta is equal to vw1 minus u1 divided by vr1. So vr1 cos of theta will be equal to vw1 minus u1. But at the outlet angle, our triangle will become like this. So So this will be my beta, where beta is greater than 90 degree. Now in this case, I can, when I am going to define my cos of phi, that is given by cos of phi is equal to u2 minus vw2 divided by vr2, because here our u2 will become this much, and after that this will be my resolving component of the relative velocity. So this will be my resolving component, horizontal component, and this will be my vertical component, resolving component of the velocity, vf2 and vw2. Now when my beta is greater than 90 degree, at that time my vr2 cos of phi will become u2 minus vw2. Now by simply putting this equation in our equation of the force, what we will get here, rho a vr1 multiplied by vr1 cos of theta plus minus, so here it is plus, that equation we have already discussed. So by putting the value of vr1 cos of theta and vr2 cos of theta when beta is greater than 90 degree, vw1 minus u1 plus u2 minus vw2. So again this u1 and u2 are equal, and I can simply deduct it, plus and minus. So what equation I am getting here, f of x is equal to rho a vr1 multiplied by vw1 minus vw2. Now this equation will be applicable when my angle beta is obtuse angle, that is beta is greater than 90 degree. So in general, what I can write here, in general I can simply write down this equation as rho a vr1 vw1 plus minus vw2. So I can simply write down this equation in general, which is given by f of x is equal to rho a vr1 in bracket vw1 plus minus vw2. Now when you need to consider the plus sign and when you need to consider the minus sign, just look at here. Take positive sign when beta is less than 90 degree, take negative sign when beta is greater than 90 degree. And now when beta is equal to 90 degree, in that case our outlet velocity triangle will be look like this. If you see here, this will be our outlet velocity triangle, and if my outlet velocity triangle is look like this, in that case whatever my vw2 component will be the zero, because there is no resolving component of the v2, and in that case my v2 will be equal to vf2. And if this v2 is exactly equal to 90 degree, and if no resolving component, in that case simply put the value of vw2 is equal to zero. So if you put the value in this equation as vw2 is equal to zero, our reduced equation of the f of x for that condition will be equal to f of x is equal to rho a vr1 multiplied by vw1 when my beta is equal to 90 degree, in that case vw2 will be equal to zero. Hope you understood this derivation. Remember this equation of the force exerted by the jet in case of unsymmetrical moving curved vane. Hope you understood this derivation. In the rest of the things, work done per second and efficiency, we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you for watching.